of what's going to be a great weekend of Derby. Whenever they announced this back earlier in 2013, I couldn't wait for them to finally get this one underway. The D2 tournament, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Absolutely. Here's a bunch of teams coming together that we haven't seen in the regionals that we had previously, getting ready to show off their stuff and show us what they can do.
We will get underway with action here in just a second as we see Make It Rain for Omaha. They are going to be in the black jerseys with the crest on the front of jerseys, going against Unaho of Treasure Valley. They are in the white with the pink track and accents on the forearms. As we see, Make It Rain will be your lead jammer here for Omaha very early on in our first jam here of our first bout here on a Friday morning session here in Des Moines. So it is Unaho wearing number... Well, we will look at the official lineups for both squads here in just a little bit. Actually, we will take a look at the rosters right now, Bangers and Smash, and we will start off first here with Treasure Valley.
All right, and skating for Treasure Valley in this matchup, we've got number 18, 24, Cougar Crush, number 19, Riotacha, number 19, 59, Demolition Barbie, number 208, Utahoe, number 314, Lemon Harangue Die, number 462, Dawn of the Shred, number 5, Raggedy Annihilation, number 514, Smack Skellington, number 567, Goddamn Savage, number 630, Scarlet Danger, number 66, Aurelia Spine, number 8, Whip Jagger, number 8338, Anna Highway to Hell, and number 951, Sinister Skate. And let's see who's for the Omaha Roller Girls.
We will take a look at that lineup here in just a little bit. Right now, your score 4-0. Second jam in, as it is, Rady Rock as your lead jammer here for Omaha. And we thank you very much. And we are getting everything all tied down and ready to go here as we start this action here on WFTA.TV. As we said once before, it is Treasure Valley. They are the number 10 seed. They are sporting the white colors with the pink accents. And it is Omaha in all black. It is Rady Rock as your lead jammer here. And she will call off the jam. We'll get the official collection of points. Looks like she will pick up 3. And Omaha will have a quick sprint out of the gates here right now. 7-0. Omaha on top. So two back-to-back lead jams here for Omaha. They are the number 7 seed coming into this contest. And let's take a look at their lineup right now. They start out there. Number 101, Sharon Misery. Also number 1303, Forbidden Fruit. Number 26, Texas Viper. Number 3, Home Sweet Homes. Number 39, Midlife Crashes. Number 402, Make It Rain. Number 42, Axel Rogue. Number 665, Daisy Mayhem. 6 feet is Denelia In Ya Coffin. Also, it is Rady Ruck, who picked up 4 points earlier on in this contest. She wears number 77781. In is Bobby Backseat. F5 is Anti-Embolism. Number G30 is Skateaway Faye, and MK80 is Molly Maxaker. It is Treasure Valley getting their first lead jam of this contest. It's Demolition Barbie as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. With Demolition Barbie, we will get the full complement of blockers here right now early on. It's a 7-0 lead into our third jam into this contest. As we said, Omaha number 7, the 7th seed coming into this contest. Treasure Valley, we'll talk about their magical year here in just a little bit. They are the number 10 seed. 5 quick points picked up there by Demolition Barbie for Treasure Valley. As we said, this is their first appearance here in the WFTA playoffs. In fact, a lot of the teams here playing this weekend in Des Moines, it's going to be their first trip to the postseason. Another 5 and a lead change right now for Demolition Barbie. It's a 10-7 lead here for Treasure Valley.
And if you're watching there on the TV, you can see Treasure Valley with only 2 jammers in the pack doing a really good job holding back Omaha's jammer, number 630. But she does finally just make her way out of the pack.
Skateaway Faye giving close chase. She's now looking to pick up points herself. Meanwhile, it's Demolition Barbie looking for her 3rd scoring pass. Gets on through, and we'll see if she got them all here. We'll get the official confirmation of points. Yes, they give her all 5. So 15 points just like that. Treasure Valley has turned this one around. An 8-point lead here for the ladies from Boise, Idaho. So Treasure Valley, what an incredible story they've had here in 2013. A couple of weeks ago, they didn't even think they were going to be in the doggone thing. They come in as a number 64 seed when the final rankings were released a couple of weeks ago. But they got the invitation to the big dance, and they truly are a true unknown commodity here this weekend.
True. This is absolutely true. They've never played any of these teams. It's very interesting to see what they're going to do in this bout, and we'll get right back into the action, Muck.
Right now it is Utaho for Treasure Valley, looking to gain the lead, and she does here. So Treasure Valley with back-to-back lead jams here. They're currently up by 8 points. It's Midlife Crashes jamming here for Omaha. She escapes the pack as well. First scoring pass forthcoming here for Utaho. Nice hard work there by the front line there of Treasure Valley. Utaho will call it off. And a nice roll of points here. We'll call it 19 straight here for Treasure Valley. They sport the 19-7 lead here in this first bout early Friday morning, and we'll have ourselves an officials timeout. We welcome you here to Des Moines, Iowa. We couldn't wait for this one to get here. The first of two big weekends of action featuring the top squads that are classified as Division II here in this 2013 campaign of the WFTDA. And of course, we got a full slate of bouts to be bringing to you throughout the course of the day. Six overall, and you'll see it live in a living color right there at home for absolutely no cost. This weekend and next weekend in Kalamazoo will be complimentary here of WFTDA.tv, but we will have the pay system coming up for the D1 tournament and, of course, for the championships.
I will say there is a support us button on the Wolf the TV, or the WFTDA.tv website. If you'll click that, if you're enjoying the broadcast, and just give a little bit to show that you appreciate all the hard work that goes into bringing this to you over the web, that would be great. And can you tell us who's up on the Zombie Burger start line there?
Absolutely. Huh? Going up to the line for her second rotation here for Treasure Valley. It will be number four. I'm sorry. The jerseys were in a bit of a disadvantage here as far as how far back we are, but I do know for Omaha at the line it is Make It Rain, getting ready to jam here for Omaha. And we will get back underway after this timeout. 24:56 left to go here in our first period of play. A 12-point lead here for Treasure Valley. And sprinting out into the front of the pack, it is Dawn of the Shred. She will be your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. So three straight lead jams in a row here for Treasure Valley, looking to seize opportunity and momentum early on. On the other end, it is Make It Rain, giving close chase as well. So Treasure Valley, very smart play. She will call it off as Dawn of the Shred looks to collect 2 points out of that rotation here. So 21 uncontested. It's a blackjack with an ace and a king there thrown down. And actually, we'll add one more with our score right now, 22-7 with 24-20 left to go here in our first period of play. If you're just now joining us, this is number 7 versus number 10, Omaha, as we saw them last year with a nice streak in the region formerly known as the South Central, notching up 7th place in the postseason last year. Right now, their record stands at 3-8. Treasure Valley is at 6-2. It's their first time ever in the postseason, and so far, so good, as Bemolition Barbie will be your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley.
Treasure Valley really coming off the line here and showing their stuff with a 6-2 win-loss record this past year. This really shows you how they're coming in. They could potentially make this happen for Treasure Valley. Some amazing skill here, taking lead jammer 4 times in a row now.
Yes, they have looked very, very solid, very methodical points being posted here. We did have the big 15-pointer notched up by Barbie a couple of rotations ago. That's what's extended this differential out to 26-7, 23-20 left to go here in our first period of play. At the line, it's going to be Rady Ruck here for Omaha. And on the other side of the ledger, I do believe for her first appearance at the line, it is it's Utaho back at the line here once again. With an unknown commodity such as Treasure Valley, these are new faces that we're going to get to know as the course of the weekend continues. Utaho will be your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. So now that's 5 straight lead jams here for Treasure Valley. Rady Ruck escapes from the pack as well. But meanwhile, it is Utaho looking to notch up some points here and keep this uncontested scoring streak alive here for Treasure Valley. Gets a little assistance as well. And there's 4 big points. She'll quickly call it off. Utaho's going to make this differential now 23 points. It's 30-7 with Treasure Valley up. 30 points scored straight here by the ladies from Boise, Idaho. Looking very impressive here early on, Bangers.
And Omaha is currently skating short. You'll notice they've got a couple skaters there in the notorious RED penalty box. So this is going to be a challenge for Omaha to come back now, especially skating short two blockers, to hold back that jammer from Treasure Valley and let their jammer get through that pack.
It has been a very clean game so far here for Treasure Valley. And wow, just methodically over and over and over again, Treasure Valley notching up the leads. It's Dawn of the Shred as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. Under 22 minutes left to go in the first period of play. Midwife Crashes is jamming here for Omaha. Here comes Dawn of the Shred, looking to post up some more points and extend this differential even further in this uncontested scoring streak. Treasure Valley been very, very solid in this opening round matchup. Meanwhile, more whistles being assessed, and now a power jam coming up here for Treasure Valley. We'll get the official call here in just a little bit. Back block is the call here against Midlife Crashes. So a power jam now here for Treasure Valley. So Dawn of the Shred here trying to make a statement. She'll have five right now off of this power jam. And Treasure Valley really opening up the differential right now. 1:10 left to go in the jam. 21:15 left here in the first period of play. Second scoring pass here for Dawn of the Shred. Meanwhile, sitting in the box as Midlife Crashes. And this is a big power jam here for Treasure Valley. Nice work defensively by the three-woman wall right at the line there by Omaha. But getting through is Dawn of the Shred. And she's notched up the grand slam here for Treasure Valley. So Dawn of the Shred making this power jam very effective now. Right now, 40-7, 40 seconds left in this jam, approximately 30 seconds left in this power jam. Huge statement being made here by Treasure Valley early on, as it is Dawn of the Shred. Threw him for another five here for Treasure Valley. Under 30, and she will call it off. And another huge collection of points. We will call it 15 altogether on the jam. 45-7, Treasure Valley here with the big advantage early on from Des Moines, and a timeout's going to be taken. Give us a chance to give a little sugar and a little loving to some of our sponsors there. Smash, who we got up on the docket here?
Absolutely. Let's tell you about Rydell. It's the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. You can visit them at rydellskates.com. An interesting thing during that last jam you saw the passive offense happening there, and then you saw Omaha's blockers, once the jammer had broken that wall, moving back, trying to get back behind that wall of Treasure Valley to drive that pack forward. So that's going to be something I think we're going to see throughout this tournament, is trying to destroy that passive offense as we continue on into the first of the playoffs here in Des Moines for Division II.
Absolutely. And of course, we've talked about how exciting the journey has been here for Treasure Valley. Really, all these squads here really excited about the inaugural season of the Division II playoffs here in the WFTDA. As we said from the beginning, this weekend we see the action from Des Moines, Iowa at the Hy-Vee Hall. Next week we are on the road to Kalamazoo, Michigan, and we will see Kalamazoo, and that's going to be another great, great, great matchup. What's so great about these D2 matchups? So much parity from 1 through 10. Really, any one of these squads, like we're seeing here, Treasure Valley very early on making a statement. Number 10 seed, hey, that might be a little bit misleading.
Absolutely. And if you want to play along, you can check out the Cheeseball Bearings Bracket Bonanza. You can still go and fill out for all of the remaining playoffs that are coming up. The Des Moines one has closed as of the first whistle, but be sure to go in and fill out those for the rest. Back to the action, Muck.
All righty. We are back underway. 20:15 left to go in our first period of play. 45-7, the lead here for Treasure Valley. It is Demolition Barbie here for Treasure Valley, and it will be Demolition Barbie and as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. Midlife Crashes back into the mix here for Omaha. So Treasure Valley, once again, unofficially, 8 lead jams in a row for the ladies from Idaho, has done a really nice job of just spreading things wide open for their jammers to get on through. And another 5 posted here by Demolition Barbie extends the lead now to 50-7.
Just a clarification on that timeout from Double H there. That was actually not an official review, just they were talking about how the track is affecting some of the gameplay there.
This is the first time for Derby here at this facility, a wonderful facility that we're seeing here in Des Moines, Iowa, but it is still first time, first testing early Friday morning. Yeah, there might be a few kinks in the system early on, but that's to be expected here on a Friday morning. More points collected here by Barbie. She got an additional 5, a 10-point jam altogether, and extends this lead. Now it's 55 points straight here for the ladies from Idaho with 19:15 left here in the first period of play. As we said, this is number 7 versus number 10. The winner of this one will advance on for a game later on tonight. We'll tell you about some of the other matchups that are taking place here, and they're all great ones here in this first day of action here in Des Moines, Iowa. Back up at the line First for Treasure Valley, it's going to be sporting the number 208, and that is going to be Utaho, and she is matched up against number 402. That is Make It Rain. So Utaho, who's been very productive so far in this matchup, against Make It Rain, and both packs underway once again. It is a two-blocker advantage here for Treasure Valley. They've been working strong with the numbers early on in this one. It is Utaho around turn number one, trying to find some open space, and she does it in the straightaway. She will be early jammer for Treasure Valley. Make It Rain giving close watch as well, but once again, we're seeing Treasure Valley take advantage and seizing opportunity and using the size advantage and the numbers advantage to post up lead jam after lead jam. Points now coming here to Utaho. She will call it off, and we will get the official assessment of points. Looks like the officials will confer, have a little confab, and I'm not sure if she got any. We will soon find out. I don't see any movement on the scoreboard right now, so we will still call it at 55-7 with 18 minutes left to go in our first period of play.
Utaho coming out on the line there a couple times here, showing that she can really find her way out of that pack, put the points on the board, and have really good jammer awareness, not let that other jammer put any points on the board.
For Omaha, out there jamming, it is the triple sevens of Rady Ruck out there. She is matched up against Dawn of the Shred. And now we will finally see, after a long, long drought for lead jam, it will be Omaha now gaining lead jammer status, as it is Rady Ruck. But Dawn of the Shred giving close chase as well. Rady Ruck, no other option. She had to call that one off. And so Omaha still sitting on the goose egg. They haven't scored points since the second jam of this contest. So it's been a long scoring drought for Omaha. Right now, 59-6. Treasure Valley on top. Well, a little bit of a momentum booster, confidence booster, as you were able to get lead jam that last time out there for Omaha. So we'll see if they can turn it around and post some points on this next rotation. They send up G30, and that is going to be Skateaway Faye at the line here for Omaha. And she will be matched up against Demolition Barbie, number 1959, here for Treasure Valley. 59-7, our score, 16:50 left to go in our first period of play. As we said, if you're just now joining us, Hy-Vee Hall in Des Moines, Iowa, is where we're bringing you this Division II action to you live here and complimentary on WFTDA.TV. If you want to talk to us, the way to do it is to talk to us via Twitter, hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. Out in front, it is Demolition Barbie. She is not your lead jammer, however. It is Skateaway Faye as lead jam for Omaha. So they're looking to post some points again after a long, long drought. And it looks like Skateaway Faye will call off the jam. No points collected, though. And that will keep their score at 7 points.
Skateaway Faye making her way out of the front side of that pack really quickly. And then getting back into the pack, taking a hit from Aurelia Spine.
And it looks like we have ourselves a skater down on the track. I do believe that is Whip Jagger, number 8 of Treasure Valley. She has been very instrumental in this early sprint here by Treasure Valley. So the EMTs here at Hy-Vee Hall giving close watches. The skaters and the officials on the flat track take a knee to update you on our score. 59-7, our lead for Treasure Valley in day number one, bout number one here in Des Moines, Iowa. Taking a look at some of the other games that we got coming up for you later on here on WFTDA.TV. Immediately following this contest, great matchup between the number 8 and number 9 seeds. It's Tallahassee versus Dallas. Later on this afternoon, the DC Roller Girls versus Gent City. In our fourth game today, it's the Blue Ridge Roller Girls against Duke City. And then, of course, the winner of this bout will be taking on the top seed. That is the fabulous Sin City Roller Girls in a match that you will see tonight at 6 o'clock. And later on, we will see the Bruce City Bruisers, the second seed in this Division II playoff round here in Des Moines. They will take on the winner of Omaha Treasure Valley. So it's Omaha Treasure Valley taking on Bruce City, and it's Tallahassee Dallas, the winner of that one, facing the top seed, the fabulous Sin City Roller Girls. So we have a break in the action, 16-11 left to go here in our first period of play. So far the story in this one, a quick sprint out of the gates by Omaha, notching up the first 7 points of this contest, and then Treasure Valley went to work, and boy did they ever. First notching up a 15-point jam for Demolition Barbie, and then just adding that momentum, keeping that pressure sustained, and they've scored the last 63 points in this contest. And I guess if you're Treasure Valley, you don't tinker with the methodology right now.
Absolutely. Treasure Valley All-Stars coming from Boys Boise, Idaho, kind of an unknown in this tournament. They've never played any of the other teams that are in this divisional playoff, but they do have a 6-2 record against those other teams that they have played, and they're really showing how they've managed to have such a good record this past season, coming right out of the gate, letting a couple jams slip by them, but then picking up pretty much every other one until these last couple where Omaha's come back and made a show.
And Treasure Valley, as we said, you know, coming in originally as the 64th ranked team in the WFTDA, to tell you about the amazing journey that this squad has had. When the first set of rankings was released by the WFTDA, or the new methodology of rankings was released back in February, Treasure Valley was in at number 92. And that was an incredible leap that they have done in 6 months' time here in the WFTDA. Of course, that 6-2 record, very imperative to the big launch that they have had. And, of course, as we've seen with the new calculated ranking systems here this year, we've seen some teams drop and some teams fall. So, Treasure Valley, yeah, they're excited. They're giddy. They are very, very happy to be here this weekend in Des Moines. Still trying to assess the situation here with our down skater for Treasure Valley, as that is Whip Jagger once again, and a longtime player here for Treasure Valley. So we are giving close watch. You never want to rush situations such as these. So our technicians, our crew here at Hy-Vee Hall, taking their time. Of course, we want to hear from you at Talk 2 WFTDA. That is Talk, the number 2 at WFTDA. Tell us who you think is going to win this weekend here in Des Moines. We would like to get your predictions, your projections, which teams you're looking forward to seeing this weekend, and how you think this D2 tournament is going to progress. And tell us what you think about the new scoreboard down below here, too. That's the one thing I'm excited about this year, a brand new graphics overlay. I'm very, very excited. It'll give you more information as to what's going on in this contest here. Just one of the new features that we're going to be bringing to you on our coverage this year, our playoff coverage here on WFTDA.tv. As we said, all the action this weekend is going to be complimentary. We have made mention, we have alluded to a donation button on WFTDA.tv that you can contact, or you can give back for what we're bringing to you this weekend. I don't want to make it sound like a telethon, but it is a chance for us to continue this coverage that you're seeing complimentary here on WFTDA.tv. And the same will be said next weekend in Kalamazoo. And, of course, we do have some packages available for you for purchase when it comes to the D1 and the championship tournaments. Once again, this year you can buy them either individually or you can buy them as one complete package. Well, hello and good morning, Bangers and Smash. How are you, my friend?
I'm doing well, Mucky to Muck. And to continue your thought there, each weekend will be $12 for the D1 playoffs. Mm-hmm. You can also get the championships for $20, or you can get the entire package for $50. And you guys are lucky if you're watching today. You could actually still get the entire package for the early bird price of $45.
Wow!
At WFTDA.tv. And it's an all-inclusive viewing pass if you mm-hmm. buy the entire package. That's all four of the Division I playoffs and the championships, which will feature the two winning teams from Division II and also all the teams going on into the championships for Division I.
And why wouldn't you buy the all-inclusive package? I mean, that's a heck of a deal, $45 if you make that purchase now. So we hope that you are enjoying the stream coverage here. We are getting ready to go here. We're still checking on the situation with Whip Jagger, who is down for Treasure Valley. The technicians, the EMTs, taking their time with her. Once again, to explain how things have progressed in this bout so far, 7 points out of the gates here for Omaha, Treasure Valley with 63 uncontested. So Treasure Valley has looked really, really solid, but a difficult situation for them to see right now. They did not come in with huge numbers coming into this this division playoff. And now seeing one of their top blockers down right now, that's got to be tough to take here early on a Friday morning.
Absolutely. And looking at the benches, you can see both teams are actually conferring, using this time to kind of look at where they're at, look at how they're playing, and work out some strategy ideas as we continue to check and see what's going on here with Whip Jagger and get her taken care of.
The extended timeout continues on. Of course, in situations like this, you don't want to rush the situation. So here at Hy-Vee Hall in Des Moines, Iowa. Of course, it's the first time for Flat Track Roller Derby action here. Of course, we have talked about how great the parity is to be found here this weekend here in Des Moines, and also gives us an opportunity to talk about the very tough brackets to look at. In filling out my own this weekend, I did it in number two Pinchel because I had to erase it so many times. It's just that tough to call. And this weekend, of course, with the bracket bonanza contest that we have going on, you can't do it anymore here for the D2 here in Des Moines, but you can continue on throughout the rest of the postseason. I think all of these playoffs this year with the parity that's going to be experienced, especially next weekend at Kalamazoo, well, of course, here in Des Moines, it's going to be tough to fill out those brackets as the weeks go on.
I believe it is going to definitely be tough to fill out those brackets. Cheeseball Bearings Bracket Bonanza going on right now. You still have an opportunity to fill it out for D2 playoffs in Kalamazoo. Mm-hmm. And all of the Division Ones and the championships. You can go ahead and fill those out right now. And if you go over to WFTDA.com. There is a link right on the website there. Get those filled out, get them in, and potentially win something, I believe. Very nice.
We are still looking at the situation as we see Whip Jagger still down, and that's why we've cut it away from the track right now and have focused on us. But we can let you know that she is at least sitting upright. The technicians, once again, just taking their time and checking out the skater. They are not going to rush things here in this situation. As we said, it's 63-7 with Treasure Valley on top here with 16:11 left to go here in our first period of play. A great crowd here on a Friday morning here in Des Moines. The weather is lovely, and of course the hospitality is lovely. The Des Moines Derby Dames is our host squad here for this weekend here in Des Moines, and the hospitality has already been extended. Got an ear of corn in my announcer's packet already earlier today. So we thank them for hosting in what's going to be a very fun weekend. And actually, when you think about it, Des Moines has really embraced roller derby here this weekend. It's Roller Derby Week, as proclaimed by the mayor here of Des Moines. So they've really have welcomed WFTDA, the skaters, the fans, with open arms. It's great to see that Iowa, yeah, you got a thumbs up in hospitality so far for
absolutely.
Me.
Coming in, coming off the interstate into the city, there's a sign welcoming all the fans and the players and the people that are working this tournament. And don't forget, you can also say thank you to the people working this tournament, specifically for the broadcast. You can support us here today by going to WFTDA.tv/passes. And select Support WFTDA. Fill in any amount on the line you want, as little as 25 cents even. We say thank you very much for your support. You get to choose your own price for this weekend and next weekend. You get the full stream. If you like what you're seeing out there, help us keep doing this for you by giving just a little bit back to show you appreciate what we're doing for you.
Hey, you know what? I'm going to throw down the gauntlet, Bangers and Smash, okay? I believe in challenges. I believe in trying to kick up the donations a little bit. Here's $10 right now. Double H, I'm going to hand this over to you. How about that, okay? And she's going to give back to the cause right now. I'm throwing down the challenge right now to everybody out there. Donate $10 just for starters right now, okay? Any amount that you can do is greatly appreciated. But why not get the ball rolling? Because I love the fact that WFTDA.tv is offering this complimentary coverage this weekend. We want to keep that going for all the D2s down the road. And so with your help and your support, you can make those things happen. I'm not going to grab that $10 back from you later on. That's legit. You can give it to the guys back there. All righty, as we will continue to update the situation here right now, our score is 63-7. Treasure Valley on top. Thank you very much for your patience here in this extended timeout, which has now reached about the 11-minute mark, and we are still awaiting word, and still we have a perfect shot from where we're at of Whip Jagger's situation. She is still down on the track. She is up. She is talking with the officials right now. But we cannot see. It looks like potentially a knee injury right now. That Whip Jagger has suffered, but of course we'll have confirmation of that during our halftime here.
And don't forget, you guys can, I know we're talking a lot up here during this time. you guys are welcome to join us in the
sure.
talk. Go to Twitter, and you can use hashtag talk2WFTDA. That's hashtag talk the number two WFTDA, and give us some feedback on what you think about this wonderful new scoreboard. You see at the bottom of the screen there.
Right.
You'll even see the little lead jammer popping up
mm-hmm.
on the bottom of the screen. That's something new. That's a great new feature for this year. Let us know what you think about that. Let us know what you think about the action, what you think about what you're hearing. We are here, and if we get an opportunity, we'll let you know. The new scoreboard is actually designed by this month's featured skater,
right,
Grace Killey.
Absolutely.
Who'll be here skating this weekend, as mm-hmm. a matter of fact.
Yep. We will see her with Brew City, so thank you very much, Grace. Always doing a fantastic job with her long tenure here in the WFTDA, and she always adds a new layer to the level every year with the things that she does. So thank you very much, Grace. Gives us a chance to talk about some of the other seeded teams that are going to be here this weekend. Of course, we mentioned Brew City here at number two. I think what's interesting for Brew City's cause here is if they win here this weekend in Des Moines, they have a chance to play for the inaugural D2 tournament championship in their own backyard, because Milwaukee is hosting the D2 championships and, of course, the D1 championships this weekend. They win it all this weekend, they've got a home track advantage.
Absolutely, yeah. I'm sure that as Brew City comes into this, they are definitely going to want to be thinking about that, keeping that in their mind. They've got a couple of teams that are looking to take that spot from them, though, and Treasure Valley certainly appears to be one coming right off the line.
Okay, as you saw there just a second ago, Whip Jagger, we will give you an update here at halftime as you saw her being escorted or taken off the track there by the EMTs, and thank you very much for their cooperation and making sure that she is okay. We will, as we said, get a official update on her status coming up here at halftime. Let's reset the table for you now as we'll be getting back underway with action. 16:11 left to go in period number one. After that, 13-minute timeout. But you know what? I don't mind that at all. I mean, you definitely want to take care and say safety first in situations like that. As much time as needed as possible, I say might as well do that. But it was a lengthy drought there as far as no action on the flat track here. So we'll see if that affects, hinders, or helps Treasure Valley or Omaha. We will soon find out.
Well, in Omaha coming back with those two quick jams where they were able to take lead jammer, unfortunately not able to put points on the board, but they were coming back showing that they're in this game ready to go. I think Omaha coming back from this timeout is really looking to grab onto that and close up that score differential and get back into this game. So who's up there on the Zombie Burger start line for us?
All right, here for Treasure Valley, it is going to be Yuta Ho donning the star here for Treasure Valley. They are in the white with the neon pink accents, and on the other side of the ledger here for Omaha, it's going to be Make It Rain. So here comes Yuta Ho, here comes Make It Rain for Treasure Valley and Omaha, respectively. Back underway with action, a flat 16 minutes left to go here in period number one. After an extended injury timeout there to Whip Jagger, we'll update you on her status here in just a little bit. Meanwhile, it is Make It Rain trying to get around to the front of the pack with one skater beat. Nice work there by Treasure Valley, though, to send her outside. Meanwhile, it is Yuta Ho trying to grab the advantage here in front. Nice wall being built up there by Omaha. Still nobody with the advantage yet. 30 seconds deep into this jam. Multiplayer block being called here against Omaha. And here is your lead jammer. As we finally get the official confirmation, yes, it will be Make It Rain for Omaha. So back-to-back lead jams here for Omaha. 1:10 left to go here in this jam, and Omaha trying to notch up the first point scored since the second jam of this contest here for the Nebraskans. As we see Omaha trying to set things up here with Make It Rain, she is forced to the outside. She will have to reset. Meanwhile, it is Yuta Ho making her way around the flat track as well. Not much that Make It Rain could do. She had to call off the jam. 0-0 stalemate. It remains at 63-7 midway through this first period of play.
I want to say thank you very much to Brass Monkey. Actually took you up on your challenge there. Actually went ahead and bought the Big Five streaming, which everybody can still do and get an early bird price of $45 through August 26th.
That Funky Monkey. Thank you, Brass Monkey. Nicely done there, my friends. See, we throw down the gauntlet early on, and folks are already taking advantage of it. So thank you, my friend. I think you'll be very happy with your purchase. Daughter of the Shred, Don's the star here for Treasure Valley, matched up against Rady Ruck here of Omaha. 14th jam in here. Treasure Valley has rolled off 63 points straight here. Meanwhile, nobody with the advantage yet here on the straightaway. Being hemmed in the back of the pack is Rady Ruck. Meanwhile, trying to work around the three-woman wall. There it is, Don of the Shred. Nice work slowing things down here by Omaha. Pack is designated as Don of the Shred, trying to work his way through. And a power jam now coming once again here to Treasure Valley. As we see Rady Ruck sent off to the sidelines. We'll get the official call here in just a little bit. Meanwhile, we can officially say, oh, and now back-to-back as it will be. Dawn of the Shred sent off for a track cut. So as soon as she sits down, Omaha will now be on the power jam here with Rady Ruck. So back-to-back track cuts, I do believe, here on both squads. So now here's the advantage that Omaha was looking for with 13:30 left to go here in this first period of play. 50 seconds left in the jam. No lead jammer designated yet here as Rady Ruck and Donna Shred were both pinned in the back of a very, very active pack. Meanwhile, Dawn of the Shred sits in the sin bin. Now she finally gets back out onto the flat track. So a very, very brief power jam there for Omaha. There is still no lead jammer in this jam 14. 30 seconds left to go. And out to the front, it looks like there will be no lead jammer. So we will continue on for an extra 20 seconds, but both jammers looking to post some points. Packed pretty far away, though, from both skaters with 15 seconds left to go in this jam. We'll see if anybody can notch up any points here. Here comes Dawn of the Shred. Here comes Rady Ruck. Jam clock now showing 10 seconds as both jammers approaches as it is. Dawn of the Shred trying to work on through for a few points and does get all the way through, so she's notched up four. However, it looks like one solo point notched up there by Dawn of the Shred. They broke the scoring drought there for Omaha. They finally now have another point added to their column. Four added there by Treasure Valley. Right now, to update you on our score, 67-8, Treasure Valley on top here with 12:15 left here in the first.
Don't forget about Adam Wheels. Oh, Adam, yeah. Wheels, a proud partner of the official and the official wheel of the WFTDA. You can visit them at adamwheels.com for all your wheel needs.
What? And just like that, Demolition Barbie to the front of the pack as your lead jammer, looking very explosive off the stretch there, was Treasure Valley. So far, so good, and all the way through, and Demolition Barbie's got five here for Treasure Valley. Omaha really in a bit of a bind here. They've had way too many trips to the box here in this first period of play. A lot of four-on-two pack advantages here for Treasure Valley early on. Now we even up the numbers a little bit as Treasure Valley will send one blocker to the box there. Meanwhile, another five collected here by Demolition Barbie. So back-to-back grand slams here for Treasure Valley. Now extends this lead to 70 points. 120 left here in the jam. 11:20 left here in the first period of play. Demolition Barbie will call it off. We'll add another 10 to the tally here on the ladies of Boise, Idaho. They've now extended this lead to 77-8. Nice work here for Boise early on. And it's not so much a case of what Omaha hasn't done well. It's Treasure Valley doing things very effectively here so far. Very explosive sprints out of the gates here by their jammers. Great pack control. They have played the type of game that they wanted here on a Friday morning, and it's been very explosive early on.
Absolutely. Number 630, Scarlet Danger, was who left the pack there from Treasure Valley, going to the notorious RAD penalty box. Going to give Treasure Valley a slight pack disadvantage during this next jam. And let's go ahead and get right back into the action.
Absolutely. As we see Utaho jamming here for Treasure Valley, it's Make It Rain here for Omaha. Big tumble on the straightaway. You got a good look at that one at home. And as lead jammer, it will be Make It Rain here for Omaha. So once again, we will see if the Nebraskans can post up some points. They need some before things get a little bit out of hand here late in this first period of play. So here comes Make It Rain, gets on through with one skater to beat, and she does get all the way through. Grand slam collected here by Make It Rain in Omaha. Big points collected there. As we see, second scoring pass here for Make It Rain, looking to get around that last wall of defense, looking for the inside line into number three, and she will not be able to get on through, so she will be sent to the back once again. It is still now a power jam here for Omaha to boot, so big time momentum shifting the way here for Make It Rain and for Omaha. An additional 4 points collected here by Omaha, so that whittles the lead down now to 77-17. 19:30 left to go here in this first period of play. So the power jam here for Omaha, looking to take advantage, it will be a Rady Ruck as the lone jammer at the Zombie Burger Jammer stripe. So right now it is a one-blocker advantage here for Treasure Valley. But more importantly, we see Omaha as the lone jammer out there, that being Rady Rock with the three-woman wall to get around there and straight away of number one. As we get back underway, jam number 17, 9 minutes flat left here in this first period play. Big hits here in the front there, but getting on through, it is Rady Rock here of Omaha. She'll be your lead jammer as this power jam continues on. Udaho awaits in the queue. Meanwhile, setting up this wall here is Omaha. Effectively, nicely done here by Omaha. And another grand slam collected here by Rady Rock. So Rock here with 10 points straight right out of the get-go off of this power jam, which reaches its conclusion. Udaho back into the mix. And it will be Rady Rock calling this one off. And she'll get four more. So 14 overall there for Omaha. Nice roll of points here in the last couple of minutes of play. Meanwhile, Treasure Valley Udaho did get two out of that rotation there. 79-26 your score with 8:15 left here in the first period of play. Omaha looking really solid the last couple of rotations there, Smash.
Omaha coming out showing that they deserve to be here. They've been in the 2010, 2011, and 2012 previous playoff appearances. So they're pretty experienced with this. And speaking of experience, the experienced Derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. DerbyForAll.com.
Dawn of the Shred is your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. 7:45 left here in the first period of play. 79-26 your score. The ladies from Boise in control here in this first period of play. Midlife crashes, jams here for Omaha. She escaped from the pack as well. Both scorers, well, looks like only one of them picked up points. 4 points notched up there by Treasure Valley. So once again, they are back in the scoring column here after, well, gosh, they've pretty much posted points ever since the second jam of this contest, even in a non-league capacity here. So it's been consistent scoring here for Treasure Valley in this first period of play, Smash.
Treasure Valley is definitely showing that they are here to play some derby. Mm-hmm. And you know, when there are 295 leagues that you're battling for one of these spots with, 198 members, 97 apprentice leagues in the WFTDA, Women's Flat Track Derby Association, to make it into this top 60 spots is a really saying something for your team, especially when you come from in the 90s,
right,
to be here at number 64 in the rankings. Treasure Valley really here to show that they know derby. So.
Team timeout taken here by Omaha. That is their second of this contest, so they only have one more left for this game. Meanwhile, Treasure Valley has all three of their timeouts. And you mentioned Treasure Valley, and we look at their progression, picking up very solid wins. We saw them earlier on back in March picking up two wins, one over Slaughter County, also one over FOCO. And then they just kept that momentum going as April and May progressed there.
And they did. April with another win against Emerald City, and in May another win against Silicon Valley. So Treasure Valley really showing that they're in this game to win, and I think they've brought that game, this early morning game on Friday at the Division II playoffs. Treasure Valley really here to show that they want to take that top spot away from everybody else.
And I tell you what, they didn't show the nervous jitters that sometimes you might see a first-time playoff team have here so far. So calm, cool, and collected, they've played the type of derby that they wanted to play. It is Demolition Barbie out there for Treasure Valley, back underway with action. It is Make It Rain here for Omaha, donning the star. It's Demolition Barbie. We've said this a lot in this contest as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. Meanwhile, we see, once again, the pack thinning up once again here for Omaha, as is a power jam here for Demolition Barbie. As we see Make It Rain still sitting in the sin bin. One blocker to the box here for Treasure Valley. Nice spinorama there by Demolition Barbie. She'll pick up five here for Treasure Valley. 1:19 left here in the jam, 6:30 overall here in our first period of play. Treasure Valley looking to break open triple digits in this first period of play, and that would be a huge eye-opener here in Des Moines. You see the tough, tough walls being set up there by Omaha, but Demolition Barbie does get through, and she will score another five here for Treasure Valley. A minute left here in this jam. Demolition Barbie going to the pay window once again. Third scoring pass here. Once again, gets on through. Made that one look easy. She'll call it off. 15 on the power jam here for Demolition Barbie. Darby, and that extends the lead even further now. And yeah, they are a few points shy of triple digits. It's 98-26 Treasure Valley over Omaha with 5:50 left here in our first period of play.
And here's something to speak to the play. You know, giving up a penalty can really affect how it's going to happen to your team. So far in this bout of the Division II playoffs, Omaha giving up 11 minutes in penalties, and Treasure Valley giving up 6. And you can see that difference in the score that you see posted there on the scoreboard.
Yep, if you're Omaha, just can't do that with the 2-1 ratio right there. It's Utaho as your lead jammer for Treasure Valley with 5:20 left here in the first period of play. The lead right now stands at 62 points, 72 I should say. But could potentially be more here with Utaho, trying to post up points here with two more skaters to beat. In and around turn number 2, she will call off the jam. They do reach 100 and then some with a flat 5 minutes left here in the first period of play. She will actually get the natural grand slam, so it's going to be 103-26. Trench Valley on top here, 4:50 left here in our first period.
If you like what you're seeing out there, folks, and you have a business, a boot camp, or a tournament that you need to advertise, you can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans right through WFTDA.TV. You can advertise on WFTDA.TV. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities to learn more.
And we thank you very much for coming along for the ride. Inaugural D2 playoffs here in Des Moines at Hy-Vee Hall. This is number 7 versus number 10 with Omaha and Treasure Valley. Right now, in the front of the pack, it's going to be Donna the Shred for Treasure Valley as your lead jammer right now. If not mistaken, unofficially, that is about 18 lead jams here for Treasure Valley in this first period of play. Very dominant in the plaque controls that we have seen here from Treasure Valley. It's Rady Ruck out there donning the star and forced to the back for Omaha, but already it is a grand slam for Donna the Shred and looking to post up more for Woman Wall on the straightaway, trying to get on through. Rady Ruck really being hemmed in by nice defensive work here by Treasure Valley. And it is Rady Ruck here on turn number 2 trying to escape. But meanwhile, number 5 collected here by Donna the Shred. 10 on this jam so far. So Donna the Shred with 10 points posted here for Treasure Valley as they continue to roll on with under a minute left here in this jam. 3:20 left to go here in our first period of play. And wow, just like that, Donna the Shred posting another 5. She'll call it off. 15 altogether for Treasure Valley. That's the second time they've sported up the triple fives here for Treasure Valley. Makes the score 116-26. 3:05 left here in this first period of play. I don't know about you, Bangers, but I'm shocked. I'm amazed at this Treasure Valley output here so far, and it's great to see.
Absolutely. Treasure Valley showing that they've got jammers who know how to get out of that pack, get the points on the board, maintain awareness of where the other jammer is, and the blockers here are doing an amazing job keeping those walls tight, holding back that jammer, not giving them any way to get through. So we're back into the action, Muck. What's going on out there right now?
Absolutely. We see Demolition Barbie once again jamming for Treasure Valley for Omaha. It's Midlife Crashes, who has one skater to beat with Midlife Crashes, and she will get into the front of the pack. So Omaha will get lead jammer. Meanwhile, huge hits going on in the corner as it's Demolition Barbie feeling the demolition wall there of Omaha. As we now see Midlife Crashes looking to post some points, some much-needed points here for Omaha in the latter stretches of this first period of play. Meanwhile, it is Demolition Barbie taking a tumble once again. Points being looked to be picked up here by Midlife Crashes. 2 minutes left to go as 5 will be notched up here by Omaha. Crashes will call it off, and 5 points collected here by the Nebraskans with 1:45 left in the first period of play. 116-31, Omaha trails.
And Raggedy Annihilation and Aurelia Spine there at the very end of that jam doing a really good job. Just a 2-wall at the front of the pack holding up the blocker for Omaha, making sure that she wasn't going to put any more points on that board as we continue to come even closer to being at the halfway point of this bout. Who's up there on the zombie burger start line for
us? We have Make It Rain for Omaha. She's matched up against Utoho of Treasure Valley. And quick sprint into the front. It's going to be Make It Rain as your lead jammer here for Omaha. 1:13 left in the period clock. 1:45 left in the jam. We'll see how far Omaha continues to take this one in the latter stretches. It is a clean box for both sides as we see Make It Rain looking for her first scoring pass. Meanwhile, Utoho does escape from the pack herself. Utoho picking up a couple of points with one blocker to beat on the straightaway. Hit and sent out of bounds. Nice work there, and the jam will be called off. Give big credit there. We're going to get official confirmation on the number. Yeah, that was 630 there for Treasure Valley, and that is Scarlet Danger with a nice job of sending Make It Rain out of bounds. She had to call it off. They did get, however, a couple points on that rotation, making the score 116-35, potentially the last jam of this first period of play as the period clock shows 25 seconds. And at the line here for Treasure Valley, we'll get a quick confirmation of the jersey there. That is going to be Dawn of the Shred for Treasure Valley. It's Rady Rock here for Omaha. So time dwindling down here in this first period of play. A very productive first period of play here for Treasure Valley. The ladies from Boise have done very, very solid work here in this first period. Rady Rock, though, is going to try to end things with an exclamation point as she's going to be your lead jammer for Omaha, but fast on her trail is Dawn of the Shred. So we will see if Rady Rock can post any points, and does she even know if Dawn of the Shred is even behind her? Four-woman wall in front for both squads, and yep, she's going to have to call off the jam. Rady Rock calls it off. Scoreless jam to finish off this first period of play. One of very few scoreless jams in this first period of play, as we saw Treasure Valley with a big sprint out of the gates. Unofficially, I have them down with 55 points scored uncontested in that first period of play. Very dominant play here by Treasure Valley after Omaha notched up those first 7 points of this contest. Your overall assessment from what you saw out there in the first half, not too much to criticize if you're Treasure Valley.
Absolutely not. And even Omaha coming in strong in the game, falling off there as Treasure Valley started to take up those lead jammer after lead jammer after lead jammer, able to shut him down each time. Omaha making a comeback just before that long timeout we took, and now Omaha really showing that they're here to play too.
Right.
They're not going to give up the good fight. They are working to make this happen for Omaha. And in that last jam there, you saw Rady Ruck with some good jammer awareness,
yeah,
calling it off just in time, mm-hmm, just before the Treasure Valley jammer was able to pass one of the players.
Mm-hmm.
So Omaha showing that they've got what it takes to be here. They deserve to be here. They are going to make this happen for Omaha.
Should be a fun second half of play, as you see down below. Your score at halftime, 116-35. Treasure Valley with the lead. Of course, this is the inaugural D2 tournaments that you're watching here on WFTDA.tv. Of course, all this action that you will see here this weekend is complimentary. And of course, we have made mention, we have alluded, we have actually had personal donations already made here to WFTDA.tv. If you want to give back to the cause, we appreciate it. We hopefully will give you plenty to offer you here this weekend, because I think the action is going to be great with all the great parity that we're going to see in all this action that we're going to see with 10 great teams here in Des Moines. Of course, we want to hear from you as well. If you want to give us some feedback, hashtag #talk2, the number 2, WFTDA. That's how you can get a hold of us. Let us know who you think is going to win this weekend, not only in just in this battle here, but who you think is going to take it overall this weekend. It's going to be tough to figure out who's going to take one of those two prime spots. Remember, the overall winner and the one who finishes in second place, they both will be going up to Milwaukee. There will be a third place bout overall in D2s this year. We want to hear from the folks out there who your favorites are.
Absolutely.
Do you have any favorites? Am I going to pick your brain on this one here?
We're not going to be biased. I'm not going
right?
to show any bias.
That's
here.
Right.
But, you know, and speaking of telling us who's going to win, you
sure
can also go in to the WFTDA.com website. You can fill out that cheese ball bearings bracket,
yeah,
bonanza,
mm-hmm,
and just by having that opinion, you can actually win a very nice prize if you pick the most correct teams in your bracket. So, and that's the fun thing about doing a bracket. I know we've got a bracket
sure
contest going on here, and I'm wondering how this is going to play out and whether my bracket's going to be correct after this first game here of the season.
I think a lot of people might be second-guessing what they've selected here. But you know what? That's what is so fun about postseason. I mean, you never know who's going to take a battle, especially, you know, at a 7-10. You know, you always look forward to, of course, the 4-5 matchups, the 6-3. But even these early morning Friday bouts, there tends to be more times than not a lot of upsets that occur. We'll see if Treasure Valley can keep this momentum rolling along. Right now, they sport the 116-35 lead over Omaha. We're going to take ourselves a quick break, take ourselves about an 11-minute and 35-second timeout, and when we come back, we'll have second half action for you right here from Des Moines on WFTA.tv.
I've prepared myself for this moment. I have trained hard for this moment. I tell myself, stay focused, stay calm, see the space, and believe in your blockers. I know I trust my training. Do you? Get some athletics.
Years back, we noticed that a lot of girls playing roller derby were not wearing certified helmets. They were wearing non-certified soft foam helmets, and we were concerned. You can't control how you fall in roller derby. It's a contact sport. You're going to get hit, and you're going to go down, and this happens all the time. We've been trying to get the word out to everyone that plays roller derby to wear a helmet that is certified for multiple and single impacts. The Angel City Derby girls wear certified helmets.
Brenda Gold, and I've been at Riddell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just a one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
Hey, this is Dan from S1 Helmets. We're here at the Angel City Derby Girls practice facility, hanging out and watching them practice. A few years back, we noticed that a lot of girls playing roller derby were not wearing certified helmets. They were wearing non-certified soft foam helmets, and we were concerned. We've been trying to get the word out to everyone that plays roller derby to wear a helmet that is certified for multiple and single impacts. While we were here, Octane Jane was jamming and she got hit, snapped her head back, and hit her head pretty hard. Octane Jane was fine. That's why we want girls in certified helmets, dual certified helmets, because you can't control how you fall in roller derby. It's a contact sport. You're gonna get hit and you're gonna go down. And this happens all the time, all around the world. And if you're in the wrong helmet, you're really gonna hurt yourself. And she was wearing a lifer helmet, which is dual certified, and she got up and she's fine. So we're stoked and the helmet worked, and that's what this is all about.
And we welcome you back to Hy-Vee Hall here in Des Moines, Iowa, as we are set and ready to go for the second half of play. As you see down below, your halftime score, 116 for Treasure Valley. Omaha Roller Girls right now with 35. Alongside Bangers and Smash, my name's Muckety Muck, and we thank you for coming along for the ride on this early Friday morning to watch the inaugural D2 playoffs here for the WFTDA. Boy, so many acronyms I gotta say this early on a Friday morning, but we're happy that you come along for the ride. And first time inaugural launching, so far so good. If you're Treasure Valley, as we said, nice momentum stretch after the second jam when they were down 7-0. They're looking to keep that momentum going here in the second half.
I believe so, but I'm pretty sure that Omaha is out there reevaluating where they're at. I mean, you saw them come back there at the end of the second half, really put some points on the board, show that they're still in it to win it. Mm-hmm. They want to take this game. Omaha is going to come back after this half and show that they are ready to beat Treasure Valley, close up that score gap. And we'll see what happens here in just a few minutes when we get back into the action. Remember, you can actually join us in the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Hashtag talk to WFTDA. That's hashtag talk the number two, WFTDA. We've already got a lot of people talking on the hashtag.
Pick up bread, eggs, and milk from Hy-Vee Hall on the way home, says one. No, I'm kidding. No, actually, folks are being very nice. And we've heard that some people have already contributed to WFTDA.com or .tv so far in our complimentary cover. So we thank you very much for your donation.
Absolutely. Yeah. Just an update on Whip Jagger, who did leave after that long timeout we had. She is currently at the hospital being evaluated. Both knees are being examined. There's probably going to be an injury to at least one, maybe both. She went down really hard on both of those knees. If we get any more information on that one, we will definitely update everybody so that you know what's going on.
Yeah.
She will, I'm sure, be back skating as soon as possible. That is life in the Derby world.
That's usually how it goes. So we'll reset the table for you right now as we put a fresh 30 on the clock as we see Treasure Valley. They are in the white with the pink and neon accents, and they are taking on Omaha, the number 7 seed. They are in all black, standing at the Zombie Burger Jamba line here for Omaha. It is going to be Make It Rain, and it is Utaho. Had a very productive first half of play. She dons the star for Treasure Valley. A quick fix them up of the track. As we said once before, this is the first time that Roller Derby is playing here at Hy-Vee Hall. Polished concrete is what we're seeing. And so far, so good in our first 30 minutes of play as far as the track usage goes. So, as we get things all squared away and ready to go, keep in mind the winner of this contest here will advance and play later on this evening. They will face the second-seeded Bruce City Bruisers in a contest that takes place at 8 o'clock tonight right here on WFTDA.tv. Coming up later on after this contest here, it's Dallas and Tallahassee. That's coming up straight up at 12 noon. So we're back underway with the action. It is Omaha with the Make It Rain, and it's Utaho here for Treasure Valley as she's sports the colors and the dons the star here for Treasure Valley. So first jam of the second half, the lead jammer here is going to come to Utaho.
Utaho able to pick up lead jammer almost every time she's been out there jamming for Treasure Valley. She is one of their go-to jammers, able to really work her way out of that pack and get around quickly. And as she's coming back through the pack here, putting 5 on the board for Treasure Valley. Looks like Omaha also has a blocker going to the notorious RED penalty box. That's going to put Treasure Valley in a position to put some more points on the board as we continue in this jam. 5 more points picked up by Utaho.
Quick sprint out of the gates with 10 straight here for Utaho to start this second period of play. 1 minute flat left here in the jam. 1 minute deep into this second period of play. Third scoring pass getting on through. It is Utaho. Another 5 here for Treasure Valley. So once again, Treasure Valley making this statement, doing it with the first jam and doing it with the same methodology that we saw in this first half.
Omaha not giving up, though. You can see Omaha's jammer in there, still looking to work her way out of the pack and Make It Rain. Really not giving up the fight, but continually getting a just hit to the outside, and good job recycling here by Treasure Valley.
Utaho's going to keep this one going. Jam clock showing under 30 seconds as Utaho's looking to pick up more points. Finally, it looks like Omaha releasing their blocker from the box as it is still Make It Rain being hemmed in. And she will finally escape from the pack here as we will see more whistles, more penalties assessed here as we've reached under 10 seconds left here in this jam. This very productive first jam here for Treasure Valley and that will do it. Once again, Yudaho, very solid job by her and her blocking sister, as Yudaho takes a little tumble there at the very end of it, but she got an additional five. Big, big sprint out of the gates. 20 points overall there for Treasure Valley. They sport the 136-35 lead.
That's it. And if you're watching number 630, Scarlett Danger from Treasure Valley, an excellent blocker here, really holding up the make it rain during that last jam. Doesn't want to let her get out. Doing a really good job of staying at the front of the pack, knocking her out, and then going all the way behind the pack to make sure that she had to come in behind everybody else.
It's been a solid effort here so far for Treasure Valley. Rady Ruck runs the star here for Omaha. She wears the triple sevens, but in front it is Dawn of the Shred as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. 20 points out of the gates here for the ladies from Boise, Idaho to start this second period of play. They've been explosive here in Des Moines so far as the number 10 seed. So here comes Dawn of the Shred on the straightaway. It was Rady Ruck escaping the pack as well. So both jammers looking to pick up points on the straightaway. And nice condom work there, or I should say tandem work there, by Dawn of the Shred, as she was able to get close to a couple of points there. We will get an official assessment. Yes, 2 points collected there by Treasure Valley to extend this lead to 138-35.
Omaha continuing to give up penalties in the pack, now up to 13 penalty minutes versus Treasure Valley 6. You can see how skating clean makes a big difference in having players on the track. And that's the thing about Derby. You got to have the bodies there to be able to hold up the jammer to keep them from getting more points on the board. And Omaha still giving up those penalties in this second half.
Demolition Barty has been fierce when donning the star here in this contest. She's your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. Matched up against Midnight Crashes, who escapes the pack as well. So both jammers once again looking to pick up points. We'll see if Demolition Barbie calls this one off. Whoa, no, no, no. She will call it off now after scoring four quickly. They're out of the gates there for Treasure Valley. So just like that, another four-pointer notched up here by Treasure Valley. Boy, if they're not hitting you over the head with 15-pointers, they're just methodically rolling at you with 4 points. Hit it and quit it, and that's why Treasure Valley continues to stretch open this differential.
That is right. Let's talk about some skates. Rydell is the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. You can visit them at rydellskates.com. Get your own skates and get into this game too. You can see Treasure Valley coming from 90-something in the original seating up to 64 here at playoffs. Really making a show of it. Going to show everybody how Derby is played.
Yeah, and they are showing here very, very well with different methodologies. I mean, they're not just coming at you with one game plan. They're coming at you with a multifaceted attack, as we see Yudaho as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. Gosh, I want to take a look, and Ringster's definitely going to give us the official stats, but unofficially, you'd have to say that it's almost a 5-to-1 ratio in lead jams here for Treasure Valley in this contest so far. Five picked up here by Yudaho. Finally escaping is Skateaway Faye. First time in the rotation for her as a jammer in this contest. Under 25 minutes left to go in regulation. Treasure Valley pulling ahead and then some with additional points. No, not on that pass there, but it was five picked up there by Treasure Valley. Makes the score 147-35. Treasure Valley out of Idaho looking really solid here so far.
They are, and if you're watching them, you can see, and they've never played any of these teams, so this is their first time against Omaha, and as they hit that line, they're out there, they're assessing what's going on, and they're able to adapt very quickly to the skating style of this team. Let's see, you know, how the rest of this bout goes in it, if they continue forward, where they take it with the next team they face.
We see Donna Dushran, donning the star here for Treasure Valley, matched up against Rady Ruck, who's had a great couple of rotations in the jammer position for Omaha. Right now, with 24 minutes left, Treasure Valley, if they can maintain this pressure, they're going to be taking on the second seed of Bruce City Bruisers. Still plenty of clock time, however, though, as we see out into the front of the pack, it's Dawn of the Shred as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. Rady Ruck giving chase as well, with Dawn of the Shred looking to collect more. Boy, we haven't given enough credit to that fantastic front line of defense and offense being put up by the blockers and the pivots of Treasure Valley. They have really opened up things here for all of the Treasure Valley jammers, making things explosive. They have been a solid unit so far in this contest, and another 4 points picked up there by Treasure Valley. This has been the true definition of a team in this one here for Treasure Valley so far.
It is. They're definitely showing that they are ready to take the lead in this playoff and really bring their stuff. And you know, speaking of taking the lead, you can lead the pack with new UV ink printing at printcographics.com. That's printcographics.com.
Right on. We thank all of our sponsors for being a part of our coverage here on WFTBA.TV. It's Demolition Barbie for Treasure Valley. It's Midlife Crashes here for Omaha. Under 23 minutes left to go in regulation. It's number 7 versus number 10. The winner of this one takes on the second seeded Bruise City Bruisers. Yes, big pick me up there for Midlife Crashes. And she'll be your lead jammer here for Omaha. And you see a big smile on her face.
And here we go. Omaha going to try to show that they still got what it takes to make this happen for them. Coming back up on the pack, looking for that way to get through that wall, getting some help from the blockers. Omaha adapting to Treasure Valley now, we're seeing. Takes a hit to the outside, going to go ahead and call off that jam.
Good pick-me-up there for Omaha. We will get the official collection of points. Looks like three spots boarded there by Omaha, so they are back in the scoring column. Once again, though, unfortunately took them a long time to post up points. 8 minutes deep into the second period of play, and now they finally got their first points of this second period. So they need to pick up the pace a little bit.
Still a chance for Omaha. The real big kicker here for Omaha is going to be to stop giving up those penalties and try to put some penalties onto Treasure Valley. Treasure Valley still sitting very low in penalties, just 6 minutes so far in this entire game. Treasure Valley really showing that they know how to keep those penalties low, keep their jammer on the track and put these points on the board.
Yeah, the team makes the least amount of trips to the box is usually the ones that win the contest. As we see Make It Rain for Omaha jamming, it's Udaho for Treasure Valley. And we see Make It Rain with one blocker to beat. Make It Rain, nice move on the straightaway. Oh, but nice force to the outside there by Treasure Valley. You've got to give credit where credit is due there to Treasure Valley, doing a nice job of slowing things down.
That's right. That's going to be Scarlet Danger again. She is all over this track and holding on. I mean, she is really shown she is out there to keep this jammer from getting through. Again, you saw her there at the back, at the front of the pack, shoveling on the jammer for Omaha, not wanting to let Make It Rain get through. But Make It Rain gets through and takes the lead.
So with back-to-back lead jams, here is Omaha with about 20 and a half minutes left to go here in regulation. Lead right now 151-38. The jam is called off, but 5 points posted here by Omaha. So a nice roll of points here, whittling away, and this is what Omaha needs to do to just kind of gradually whittle away and hope the things explode in your favor here. Right now it's 151-43 with Rady Ruck stepping up to the line here for Omaha. And right now, if not mistaken, she is the only jammer up there. So that I do believe right. We have ourselves a power jam here. We're partially blocked by our officials here, which we thank en masse for their cooperation and their due diligence this weekend for helping things out here. So a power jam now here for Rady Buck once she breaks through this pack here for Omaha. And yes, we can officially say it now. So power jam here for Omaha, now trying to make things happen 10 minutes deep into this second period of play. So Rady Buck, now with the power jam, full complement of blockers out front. So they're going to try to use the numbers in front with one to beat, and she will get all the way through. So a grand slam here for Rady Ruck, who's using luck, and a nice roll of penalties here against Treasure Valley to try to boost up some points. Still a one blocker advantage here for Omaha to boot. And all the way through, 10 points now. And you can hear the Sistrin from the sidelines from Omaha. They are getting excited and giddy. Their team's rolling up some points now, 10 so far on this jam for Rady Ruck. Meanwhile, finally coming out as she escaped from the penalty box, it was Udaho, so that forces the jam to be called off. But nice roll of points, though, as it was 10 collected there by Omaha, and now the differential under triple digits as it's 151-53 with 19 minutes flat left here in this second period of play. So far, so good for Omaha here in the second half, doing what they need to do to whittle away at this differential.
Absolutely, and Omaha really making a good strong comeback with that power jam. Now we just need to see if Make It Rain can continue this streak for Omaha as we get back into this next jam.
We see Make It Rain with Omaha trying to bust on through. Matched up against Dawn of the Shred for Treasure Valley. As we said, this is day number one of action here in Des Moines, Iowa, as Dawn of the Shred will be your lead jammer for Treasure Valley. The winner of this one in the 7-10 matchup will face the second seed of Bruce City Bruisers later on tonight at 8 o'clock. Treasure Valley would love to be that team as the 10th seed. So Dawn of the Shred here looking to post points with a minute and a half left here in this jam. Finally escaping through herself is Make It Rain. So looking to post points now is Dawn of the Shred. Gets a little help out front by her blocking sister. And now she will maintain control, but she will have to call at the jam. Looks like she got a couple of them collected. 4 points for Dawn of the Shred. So once again, Treasure Valley making the differential over triple digits at 155-53. 17:45 left here in this contest.
Absolutely. Want to say thank you to Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. You can visit them at adamwheels.com. Also want to say shout out to Midge Mayhem. Thanks for talking to us on the web there at Twitter. Midge Mayhem saying we're doing a great job. She's only able to listen, so she thanks us for calling this game for her.
Right on.
You can also talk to us at hashtag talk to WFTDA.com. Let's get back to the action.
Right on, my friend. Midlight Crashes. Dawn's the starter here for Omaha. It's Treasure Valley. Demolition Barbie. Dawn's the star for them. Barbie, who has been very solid in this contest, as has the rest of the ladies from Boise, Idaho. With a big tumble there on the straightaway. Whistles being assessed. We'll get the official confirmation. Yeah, the black mark is called here against Demolition Barbie. So Midlight Crashes here is front as your lead jammer. So Omaha here on the power jam, and boy, they are really up and really cheering on their squad right now. We see multicolored pinwheels a-flowing here at Hy-Vee Hall because they see their team coming with a bit of a shift of momentum their way, but it's not going to be easy with Midlife Crashes. She does get through for five, not easy to pick up, but she does get five.
Midlife Crashes, as she came into the pack there, took a big hit from Aurelia Spine, and then Molly Massacre decides, I don't want you hitting my jammer, takes out Aurelia Spine, and Crash is able to get right back up and out of that pack.
Midlife Crashes here on the power jam. She's notched up five so far. She will call this one off, so we will reset and reload. She got an additional 3 points, so 8 altogether on the power jam. 155-60. Treasure Valley in the lead with under 16 minutes left to go here in regulation. But a nice roll of points here for Omaha. It will be Rady Ruck at the line as the lone jammer here for Omaha. Taking a look at intangibles. 3 timeouts still left over for Treasure Valley. 1 timeout still for Omaha. They burned up 2 in that first period of play. And in hindsight, good timeouts called because there was a lot of momentum being notched up there by Treasure Valley. So here comes Rady Ruck, lone jammer here for Omaha in the 11th jam of this first bout on a Friday morning here in the inaugural D2 playoffs. As we see Rady Ruck to the front, and she will be your lead jammer here for Omaha.
Treasure Valley again demonstrating that they really have strong walls, holding her back there for the first 20 seconds or so of that jam. She wasn't able to get out of that pack. She did secure the lead, but just wasn't able to get out of that pack past Treasure Valley.
Demolition Barbie back into the mix here for Treasure Valley as the power jam concludes, but points being picked up here by Rady Luck. They stand at 60 points as Omaha. They'll add a few more to this column here, as it will be an additional 2 points picked up by Omaha. 4 picked up, though, by Treasure Valley. So it was Barbie collecting points for Treasure Valley, so we will call it a 7-4 jam in favor of Omaha.
That's right, Treasure Valley coming in here, an unknown to the competition. I think a lot of people came in saying, who's Treasure Valley? How are
Who?
They going to win?
From where?
You can certainly put in your opinion about how you think all of the games are going to take off by going to WFTDA.com, clicking on the cheese ball bearings, bracket bonanza, filling out the bracket. Now, you can't do it for Des Moines anymore.
Right.
That ended after the first whistle, but you can still do it for everything else.
And if people didn't know who Treasure Valley was beforehand, they're going to get to know them by the time this weekend finishes up. Treasure Valley with Utaho out there jamming, but in front it's going to be Skateaway Faye for Omaha as your lead jammer. So Omaha with a nice roll of points here, and they will get more as Skateaway Faye works her way to the outside. 4-woman wall here by Treasure Valley slows her down. Skateaway Faye will call off the jam with 15 There are 13:50 left here in regulation. 3 points picked up there by Skateaway Faye to make the score 159-65. Yes, what you are watching is complimentary coverage of the inaugural D2 tournament here from Des Moines for the Women's Flat Track Derby Association alongside Bangers and Smash. My name's Muckety Muck. Thank you so much for joining us here on WFTDA.TV. The action you're seeing all throughout the weekend, complimentary of the good folks of WFTDA.TV.
And also to go along with that, complimentary of some of the sponsors who are sponsoring this. I'll go ahead and give a shout out to CruiseSkateShop.com, offering quality tested derby gear and guidance since 2007. That is Cruise, C-R-U-Z, SkateShop.com.
Yes, give a little love to our sponsors when you have a chance to contact them. It's Make It Rain for Omaha. Donna the Shred here for Treasure Valley. Time now becoming a factor here for Omaha as there's under 13 minutes left to go in regulation. Donna the Shred, one skater to beat. She gets in front. She'll be your lead here for Treasure Valley. So Treasure Valley, as we see now, the star pass being completed here by Omaha. So now receiving the star is Texas Viper here of Omaha. So trying to catch him off guard, but nice work there by the pivot. And that's Barbie there for Treasure Valley, sending her to the outside. So the star pass here for Omaha, the first official star pass of the Division II tournaments for the WFTDA. When you look in the history books 10 years from now, you can find that written in the chapter. As we see Omaha trying to mix things up, but there are no points being collected. Meanwhile, five collected here by Dawn of the Shred for Treasure Valley.
Now, Texas Viper was really struggling there.
Yeah.
I apologize about that. She was really struggling there, getting recycled, taking some big hits, but finally able to make her way through and out of that pack. So,
as we see more whistles being assessed, as another Treasure Valley blocker will go to the box, and this is really the first time we've seen Treasure Valley really in any kind of serious penalty trouble here in the second half. But it was another four collected here by Treasure Valley. 168-65, your lead here for Boise with 11:35. Left to go here in regulation. It's going to be down. Let's see. Yes, that will be Barbie at the line here for Treasure Valley. I do love the fact that they have the white jerseys with the bright neon pink lettering. It makes it very easiest for those of us with poor vision, but we are getting a good look at Treasure Valley here and being matched up against Demolition Barbie. It is Midlife Crashes. So Midlife Crashes, who has done a solid job here for Omaha, but wow, you see the nice work in front there by Treasure Valley. That, of course, being Scarlet Danger. We said a lot here in this contest. She is very, very talented out there for Treasure Valley. And in front, Angela Lee Jimmerich, Midlife Crashes here for Omaha, Bangers.
And Scarlet Danger coming back on the pack, running into the, or coming back on the track, running into the pack, doing a good job up front, and then getting another penalty and being sent back to the penalty box. Treasure Valley now giving up some penalties. Omaha showing that they're able to make a comeback because of that. It really does come down to penalties in a lot of cases.
Yep, Midlife Crashes as your lead jammer here for Omaha. Demolition Barbie is not your lead, but she's looking to post up some points. Time now really becoming a factor here for Omaha as we are reaching close to the 10-minute mark. Three additional points picked up here by Omaha, so it is an even 100 points as our differential right now, 168-68. More great action coming up throughout the day here on WFTDA.TV, including in our next bout. It's going to be Tallahassee versus Dallas later on. Ooh, I'm looking forward to this one. It's DC versus Jet City, Blue Ridge versus Duke City, and of course the winner of this one takes on Brew City. The winner of Dallas-Tallahassee takes on the top seed, the fabulous Sin City Roller Girls.
A little shout out to Little Loca from Suburbia. Just checking in on Talk to WFTDA on the hashtag there. She says she's excited to see everybody in Kalamazoo next weekend.
And yes.
I hope she's excited to be watching us out there today as we bring all this Division II greatness to you today.
And I tell you what, Kalamazoo, Kalamazoo, they are all wound up as well for these D2 playoffs, as is everybody here this weekend here in the WFTDA in Des Moines. Right now it is Rady Rock as your lead jammer here, but she will quickly call it off, so it makes it a 100-point game still at one, 68-68. 9:10 left to go here in regulation. Of course, we thank our fine sponsors that are bringing us this action here, and we thank you for watching on WFTDA.tv with this complimentary footage. Of course, our footage, yeah, it's live stream coverage here this weekend. And of course, if you would like to make a donation, you can find out more by visiting WFTDA.tv. You'll find out all the information on how to do it. Hey, and we thank the folks that are already donating early on this morning on a Friday. Getting people to part with money early on a Friday morning when they're still waking up, that's not the easiest thing to do, but we were able to make it happen for a little bit. Thank you, folks, for watching and coming along for the ride. It's Dawn of the Shred, Dawning the Star here for Treasure Valley. It's Omaha, Skateaway Faye. And in front, it's going to be Dawn of the Shred as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley.
Once again, Treasure Valley just showing that they want to dominate in this competition, taking that lead jammer after lead jammer, and continually keeping their penalties low. At last check, we were 18 minutes for Omaha, 10 minutes for Treasure Valley. I know they've picked up another one or two since then, but still, lower penalties, higher score. Typically, that's the way it's going to work out.
Dawn of the Shred here looking to post up some points. The lead still at 100 at 168-268. 8 minutes flat as Treasure Valley is going to be looking to move on to take on the second seeded Bruce City Bruisers. So far, so good. You got to be happy if you're watching from Boise. Right now, five collected here by Dawn of the Shred. 1 minute flat left here in the jam. 7:45 left all together here in regulation. And this one will be called off by Dawn of the Shred. She will pick up the additional four. So nine all together there by Treasure Valley, extending this lead even further.
And another Omaha blocker headed to the box there. If you're keeping track at home, we do already have two people, one from each team, with five penalties already on the board as we're in this bout. Number 665, Daisy Mayhem, with up to five. And number 630, Scarlet Danger, who you've heard a lot about today, really playing her heart out there, has picked up five as well. So they're going to have to be careful as we play this last 7 minutes of the bout here.
And keep in mind, we did see Treasure Valley early on in this contest losing a skater, Whip Jagger. We gave you an update on her. We'll keep you up to date on any further action or progression in her situation. A tough, tough loss there for Treasure Valley, but I know the athlete that she is, she'll be back in the mix as soon as possible. It is Demolition Barbie as your lead jammer here for Treasure Valley. They are rolling along with the 177-68 lead, 6:45 left here in period number two. Escaping through the pack, it is Rady Ruck. She's had a solid second period of play here for Omaha. It is a one-blanker advantage here for Treasure Valley, as it is Demolition Barbie calling off the jam, and she will pick up. And at the very end of that jam, she's called for the track cut, so she's going to have to sit down, and it will be a lone jammer out there for Omaha. 4 points picked up there by Treasure Valley, but Omaha going to take advantage here, and we will have ourselves a timeout called here with 6:16 left here in regulation, and in Omaha with the power jam forthcoming.
Absolutely. That's going to make Omaha very, very happy. And you know what? Grace Killey and WFTDA.TV have launched this wonderful new scoreboard for us that you're seeing out there. And what we really would like to know is, what do you fans think about the new scoreboard? And you'll see the little lead pop up next to the jammer and things. I personally find it to be very, very nice scoreboard there.
Right.
But yeah, give us some feedback at hashtag TalkToWFTDA on Twitter. You can also hashtag TalkToWFTDA on Facebook. We'll take a look at that. We really appreciate the feedback on that new scoreboard you're seeing this year. A lot of work went into developing that. And you can see, like right now, we're in a review according to the scoreboard. You can see the refs all congregated out there. That's a nice little way so that you kind of have an idea what's going on there.
Gives us a chance to cheat, too.
Absolutely,
lets us know what's going on. Yes, just one of the additional functions and features that we're featuring on this year's stream coverage here on WFTDA.com. Of course, as you see, the new scoreboard being implemented down below. We will be honest. I think transparency is honesty is the best policy sometimes. We're working with a smaller crew this weekend here. Not as many camera angles as you would normally see. But we are actually doing very well with the small resources that we have here. The picture looks great so far. No problems, no issues. Hopefully I didn't jinx myself. And the folks are really having a fun time watching at home. My good friend John Maddening also posting up on WFTA.TV on the hashtag. What's he got to say there? Is he being surly?
Looks like he is saying, thanks for busting my bracket, Treasure Valley. It looks like Treasure Valley really is going to come out strong in this one, unless some magic happens for Omaha during this power jam and they're able to continue to get power jams. Treasure Valley is likely going to come out on top in this first bout of the Division II playoff.
I was working with John Madding, got a chance to talk with him last week as Minnesota came down to arch rival, play a great D1 matchup there, and he and I are both very excited about the upcoming D2 playoffs, as well as all of the playoffs when you think about it. The Big 7 coverage this year with the new methodology of seeding teams and who goes where. It's going to bring up some very interesting brackets. And as John Manding mentioned himself, his bracket already being busted. I think a lot of folks weren't anticipating Treasure Valley to be quite the explosive juggernaut that we've seen here in this early morning matchup.
Absolutely. Treasure Valley just really coming out of the box. Like yep. I said, and I've been saying this all along, they were definitely an unknown coming in. None of these teams have ever played them. They're coming in here to show, hey, we're going to just match you and take and dominate this competition.
We will get the official call on that extended timeout and what was under review here in just a little bit, but we're back underway here with 6:05 left here in regulation. Well, as we see, Demolition Barbie jamming for Treasure Valley, Midlife Crashes for Omaha, and to the front it is Midlife Crashes as your lead jammer for Omaha. Time now really becoming a factor with under 6 minutes left in regulation. Treasure Valley sporting the 181-68 point lead. With Midlife Crashes here, looking to post up some points, and it has not been easy for Omaha to post up points overall. The blocking schema here for Treasure Valley has been very effective in this contest.
Yeah, Treasure Valley, the blockers in the pack, have a very good jammer awareness. They're watching for where that jammer is at. They're able to stretch out that wall as long as possible. As you see them coming into the wall here, you see in the wall, each blocker taking up a position along the way until they have to let the jammer go. That's a good strategy when you're in a power jam situation. You have to stop the jammer from putting as many points on the board as possible.
Five picked up there by Omaha, makes the score 81-78. Treasure Valley with the advantage. As we said, the winner of this one plays Bruce City in a contest later on. Bruce City, the number 2 seed. They would love to win this weekend here in Des Moines and play the first D2 championships in their own backyard come November.
Just found out about that official review. That was Treasure Valley calling the official review to find out whether that cut happened before or after the whistle, and it looks like the cut did stand.
Yep, so we get back underway as we see Demolition Barbie back into the mix, who was sent off for the track cut. And immediately, just like that, Skateaway Faye is going to be called for that infraction. So it is Demolition Barbie as your lead jammer power jam here for Treasure Valley. So with Demolition Barbie with 4:20 left to go here in this first round matchup between Treasure Valley and Omaha. Demolition Barbie looking to put the exclamation point here on the board for the ladies from Boise. Demolition Barbie, very solid work, as has been everybody here for Treasure Valley in this opening round. And 5 posted up there by Demolition Barbie.
And again, you see here, Omaha able to do the same thing Treasure Valley was doing during the and what a great apex jump there, right in the middle of my explanation. Thank you so much. That was a beautiful jump to the inside there around the apex, putting all those points on the board.
Swiss power jam continues on, under 50 seconds left to go in the jam in about 3.5 minutes. I think some people here in Des Moines are a little shocked by what has transpired here in this first round matchup. We knew that Treasure Valley was going to be an extremely competitive squad coming into this Des Moines playoff round, but I think some people are a little shaken and taken aback by just how dominant they have been in this contest. By all means, Omaha, when you look at it, they were 7th place in the South Central last year, and they have just had a heck of a time here against a multifaceted Treasure Valley team. As it is, Demolition Barbie still is your lead as the power jam reaches its conclusion. She'll call it off. 3 minutes left to go in regulation. 200 points and then some on the board here for Treasure Valley. It's 204-78. Wow. Very, very impressive here by Treasure Valley. It's been a very impressive output here by the ladies from Boise, Idaho. I guess we can kind of somewhat officially say now we will see them later on tonight against Bruce City. And if you're Bruce City, you've got to pay close watch to what happened in this contest. You've got a very hot squad you're playing on tonight. later in the nightcap.
Absolutely, and they're very adaptable, too. We've seen that in this play. Omaha continuing to try to change up their strategy here, but Treasure Valley able to answer him right back and just dominate in this game.
It is Yuta Ho donning the star for Treasure Valley. It's Ray Ruck here for Omaha, and we will not see anybody. Looks like it will be Power Jam, yes, here for Omaha, as it will be Yuta Ho sent off for the infraction. Altogether, relatively clean contest here for Treasure Valley. As we see the pivot now going off here, that is Axel Rogue for Omaha. Rady Rock here on the Power Jam for Omaha, trying to save face here in the latter stretches here of this first day matchup here between Omaha and Treasure Valley. Jam clock showing 115, 140 altogether in the period clock, and more points being assessed here by Omaha's Rady Rock.
Scarlet Danger out on the track, up to six penalties now, so needs to play clean during this last jam just to make sure that we don't have our first seven penalties gained in one bout during this game here.
Yeah, you don't want to be known as the first skater to officially foul out of a D2 playoff round. That's the kind of history that you don't want following you around. Things looking up here for Rady Ruck. Hey, you can't be down on this squad. They got a lot of derby to play this weekend, so they want to end on a high note. Rady Ruck here will call off the jam, and with a flat minute left here in regulation, Treasure Valley, well, for a team that's been very dominant, they are pretty much laid back and quiet. They said, yep, we're just going to come in and have that blue-collar mythology and do very well in this first round matchup. And looks like more penalties being assessed as we are getting a look at the lineups here.
And 665, Daisy Mayhem also at six now as we continue into this next jam. So it's somebody may earn that moniker of being the first person to foul out in a Division II playoff in this game. It's still a possibility.
Still a possibility. Only about 24 seconds left here in regulation as this will probably be the final jam of this contest. Midlife Crashes will be your lead jammer here for Omaha, matched up against Yuta Ho of Treasure Valley. And we will see. It looks like, no, it is Midlife Crashes calling off the jam, and a timeout is going to be taken here by Omaha with 7 seconds left on the period clock and a 204-87 lead here for Treasure Valley over Omaha. It gives us a chance to say hello to some of our fine sponsors who's taking care of this broadcast coverage this weekend. And Bangers and Smash, who we got up on the docket?
Well, we've got the official skate of the WFTDA.
Mm-hmm.
Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. It's Rydell Skates. You can visit them at RydellSkates.com. Now, if you are keeping track of penalties at home, we're currently standing at 22 penalty minutes for Omaha, 16 penalty minutes for Treasure Valley. Mm. You can see how that kind of does play into the right. Into that score difference there. A big difference between number of penalties given. We've got two players potentially at that foul out point, one more penalty to earn, and they'll be fouled out of the game. Very likely this is going to be our final jam of the game. I don't see anybody up on the line, but some of the numbers I can't see yet that's in danger of fouling out.
Looks like we have at the line here for Treasure Valley, who are going to leave this first round matchup a big, big victor here over Omaha. It will be Dawn of the Shred donning the star for them. On the other side of the ledger, it is number 39. That's Midlife Crashes for Omaha. So final jam probably here in this first round matchup between 7 versus 10. And yes, this one is an upset, ladies and gentlemen, as it is Midlife Crashes as your lead jammer for Omaha.
Omaha going to come back and say, you know what, we're not going to let this end on a sour note.
Nope.
For us. We're going to put some more points on the board or at least take that lead jammer position from you this one last time, and you'll see us later on in this competition, and we're going to shine.
So Omaha here looking to put a little bit of smiles on the faces of their fans watching here this morning here on WFTDA.TV, as we will see Midlife Crashes picking up big, big points. There's 4 on the column there for Midlife Crashes. So they're going to be content to keep this one going with 1:15 left to go here in this jam. Treasure Valley, as Dawn of the Shred finally escapes herself, will be looking to post points as well as Midlife Crisis sent down, and she will look for instructions. She will call off the jam, and Nope, looks like the penalty was being assessed to her before she could call it off, so she's going to go sit down. And so the power jam's coming up here to Dawn of the Shred in Treasure Valley. So we are going to go the full 2 minutes in this one here, Bangers.
That's it. And now Treasure Valley gonna have to finish us off here as we see the last 50 seconds, 40 seconds of this jam go by. Once again, speaks to giving up those penalties, especially a power jam in the last jam. Omaha, though, coming back, putting some more points on the board, showing that they're here to play as well. It's been a very exciting first game, even though it was game two.
Right, exactly. As we see Dawn of the Shred, her sister, with 15 seconds now left to go here in regulation. As we see Treasure Valley, they have made a statement here in Des Moines on the very first bout, in the very first bout of D2 tournament play here. And if this is a foreshadowing of things to come, this one's going to be a fun weekend at Hy-Vee Hall. There's the official whistle as we will get the official accumulation of points. An additional four notched up there by Dawn of the Shred. Your unofficial final, it's Treasure Valley, the number 10 seed with the upset victory over Omaha, the 7th seed, 222-93, Bangers.
Just some absolutely amazing play by Treasure Valley, coming in, never played anybody, came from a 90 seed up into the 60s. 64 is where they fell at the last update, and then coming in here and showing that they really know how to play this game. They're really adaptable, able to get out there, get on the jam line. That whistle blows. They see what the other team is doing. They're able to adapt very quickly. As you see, Treasure Valley taking their well-deserved victory lap there. Omaha congratulating. Omaha coming out strong initially, playing a good game throughout. Treasure Valley just able to out-adapt them there.
Taking a look at what holds in the future for both these squads. Of course, Omaha goes on to play in the second seed, or I'm sorry, Treasure Valley goes on to play the second seed of Bruce City Bruisers in a matchup tonight at 8 o'clock Central right here on WFDA.TV. Meanwhile, Omaha moves to the consolation bracket. Their next matchup will take place Saturday morning at 10 a.m. Who their opponents will be determined to hear later on. Wow, Treasure Valley, as you see down below on that brand new spanking scoreboard there, 222-93, team effort here by Treasure Valley. You got to give a thumbs up to the effort. Omaha, they still got a lot of derby to play this weekend, so they can't get down. But Treasure Valley, wow, what an impressive way to kick off this tournament, my friend.
Absolutely. And Omaha walking away with this, knowing that they were still able to take that lead jam and put some more points, even up to that last jam. I think they're going to do fine later on in the tournament. Here's the thing. If you were keeping track of those penalties at home, 24 penalty minutes for Omaha at the end of that game, 19 for Treasure Valley. Mm-hmm. You can definitely see how penalties play into affecting the score of a game.
Incredible output here by Treasure Valley, 222-93 victors over Omaha. And that's just game one, ladies and gentlemen. We got all kinds of great action to be bringing to you throughout the course of the day. Coming up next, it is the battle of number 8 versus number 9, Tallahassee versus Dallas. Of course, the winner of that one will be taking on fabulous Sin City. I look forward to seeing the progression of both these squads that we just saw in this matchup here. I know a soft spot for a lot of folks at home for the underdogs here for Treasure Valley, but Omaha, you got a lot to be really optimistic about as well. How things progress this weekend, it's anybody's guess, because I think that's what the glory about the D2s are all about this year.
That is true. I've even seen some people from Idaho, Boise area on talk to WFTDA already commenting that now you know who Treasure Valley is, and that is surely the case after this last bout. You definitely know who Treasure Valley is. I think later on this evening, Bruce City is going to have their have their game faces on to take on Treasure
Valley.
They
most definitely better. Final score once again, 222-93. The victory comes here to Treasure Valley. We're going to take ourselves a quick timeout, and when we come back, we will have 8 versus 9. It's Tallahassee versus Dallas for Bangers and Smash. My name is Muckety Muck. Thank you so much for watching us here on WFTDA.TV at Des Moines, Iowa, the D2 playoffs.
Gold, and I've been at Rydell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
Hey, this is Dan from S1 Helmets. We're here at the Angel City Derby Girls practice facility, hanging out and watching them practice. A few years back, we noticed that a lot of girls playing roller derby were not wearing certified helmets. They were wearing non-certified sock foam helmets, and we were concerned. We've been trying to get the word out to everyone that plays roller derby to wear a helmet that is certified for multiple and single impacts. While we were here, Octane Jane was jamming, and she got hit, snapped her head back, and hit her head pretty hard. Octane Jane was fine. That's why we want girls in certified helmets, dual certified helmets, because you can't control how you fall in roller derby. It's a contact sport. You're going to get hit, and you're going to go down. And this happens all the time, all around the world. And if you're in the wrong helmet, you're really going to hurt yourself. And she was wearing a Lifer helmet, which is dual certified, and she got up, and she's fine. So we're stoked, and the helmet worked, and that's what this is all about.
Are you tired of slipping through slippery corners? Fed up with slipping on slippery surfaces? Introducing the Villain from Radar Wheels. Stride confidently through corners without slipping out. The Villain digs and holds through the corners like no other. Grips on even the worst surfaces. But don't take our word for it.
I hate sliding out. The Villains were so grippy, I felt like I was totally in control. The wheels are really grippy. They were really grippy, but they were still so fast.
Skater approved. The Villain and Villain Wide by Radar Wheels. Order now!